So hello and welcome to official YouTube channel of Mathematics and Beyond. We are working to give a better insight into the mathematical concepts. Today we are going to study and understand the concepts of matrices and determinants. So let's start.
So let us start matrices and determinants. Before starting matrices and determinants, let us go into a flashback. Let us imagine, let us think, let us remember what we learned in class 10th. In class 10th, we read a chapter or we learned a chapter that is the chapter number 3 of class 10th Mathematics NCERT book, that is the system of linear equations in two variables, in which we saw that the general equation of a linear equation in two variables is of the form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. And we also know that any linear equation can be represented as a straight line in a 2D plane, that is a Cartesian plane. So also we know that general form of a pair of linear equation is of the form a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. And we also know that these two lines can also be represented as a line on a 2D plane. These two equations can also be represented as a line on a 2D plane. So till here we have learned that a general form of a linear equation is of the form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, where a and b are constant and x and y are variables. Also, the general form of a pair of linear equations where x and y are variables is of the form a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, where a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2 are constants. And we have a property that a1 square plus b1 square is not equal to 0. Also, a2 square plus b2 square is not equal to 0. To solve the two equations algebraically is just to find the point of intersection of these two lines. That means, if in a Cartesian plane, we have two lines that are intersecting each other, at a point, then that intersection point is known as the solution of the given two equations. And if we have another system of equations where two lines are parallel, as in this example, since you can see these two equations are parallel, so therefore it means that there is no solution of this system of equations. So we get to know that if two lines intersect each other, there is one intersection point and it is a unique solution of the given system of equations. And when two lines are parallel, there is no solution of the system of equations. And also we have a third type of case where we can have two system of equations to be coincident to each other. What? Coincident to each other. Like this. two system equations coincident to each other. You must be feeling that it is only one, but there are actually two which are coincided with each other. These are the examples of the type that I was talking about. Here we have a pair of lines. The x minus 2y equal to 0, 3x plus 4y minus 20. If you plot this on a graph, according to like you did in last year, you will get a 1 by 2, 1 by 3, this. You will get a graph in which these two lines are intersecting each other. That means they have only one unique solution. This happens when a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. You can see. You can also see by giving more examples of your own. Now second, that is the infinite solution, coincident lines. We have this system of equation. In this, all a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2 are equal. All ratios are equal. This is very important. That is with another color, that is green. And in third, there is no solution, parallel lines. We can see that a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, but it is not equal to c1 by c2. In this type of ratios, it gives a parallel line or no solution. So from the cross multiplication rule that we learned to use last year for system of equation, for example, we take as a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, there can be three cases. That is, these two lines can be intersecting, or these can be parallel, or these can be coincident. So we take case 1. In this case 1, we assume that the two lines are distinct. This means they will not coincide. Distinct and not parallel. Not parallel. Therefore, these two lines intersect each other. These two lines must. These two lines must intersect each other. And we know this can only happen if a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. So this implies that a1 b2 minus b1 a2 is not equal to 0. So therefore, unique solution exist if and only if a1 b2 minus b2 a2 is not equal to 0. Now case 2. We consider that the two lines are distinct, that is, they are not coinciding, and parallel. So this means that these two lines are parallel. So there must be this ratio, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, not equal to c1 by c2. So this case only happens if and only if this ratio happens. So this part is actually complementary to the case 1. In case 1, we had a1 b2 minus b1 a2 not equal to 0. Here we have a1b2 minus b1a2 is equal to 0. You can see here we have not equal to 0, but we here have equal to 0. Also here we have that a1c2 minus a2c1 is not equal to 0, nor b1c2 minus b2c1 equal to 0. Both are not equal to 0. So here this condition applies. Now we go for the third case. In case 3, we have that these two lines are not distinct, that are they are coinciding lines. Here, this is can be the remaining part of the case 2. Here we have a1b2 minus a2b1 is equal to 0. Also, we have that a1c2 minus a2c1 is equal to 0. Also, we have that b1c2 minus b2c1 is also equal to 0. That is a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2. So now we will conclude all these cases in one box. So we have concluded all the information in the box. Here a1 minus b a1 into b2 minus a2 into b1. If it is not equal to 0, that is the result is non-zero, then the solution exists and is unique. That is unique solution, that the lines are intersecting. In this, the lines are intersecting at a particular point. And if a1 and b, and in this case, this remains uncertain, we don't require, as this gives, then we know that the solution is unique. And when a1 into b2 minus a2 into b1 is equal to 0 and this is not equal to 0, then solution is inconsistent. We know that case a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2 one case. Okay, this is a parallel one case, parallel line case. And here all equal to 0, then we are coinciding line case, so the infinite number of solutions. Now from this table, we can conclude a very important thing. We can conclude a very important thing that this line are consistent, inconsistent, that means they are parallel, coincident, or intersecting can be decided on the basis of a1b2 minus a2b1, b1c2 minus b2c1, and c1a2 minus c2a1. It is very important. Out of all the three I wrote, this a1b2 minus a2b1 is the most important, as on this, if it is 0, then the system equation does not have a unique solution. If it is not equal to 0, then the system equation has a unique solution. So it is important for the existence and the non-existence of the unique solutions. So in any system of equations, if this is not equal to 0, then the system equation will have a unique solution. So this quantity a1b2 minus a2b1 is known as the determinant of the system. On the basis of this, we can determine whether the system will have a unique solution or not unique solution, determinant of system.
It has a special symbol for itself that is like this. 2 modulus. Then we have A1, A2, B1, B2. To arrive at this symbol, one looks at the system of equations, takes XY terms in their proper positions and simply writes the coefficients as they appear in the equations and draw 2 vertical lines on either side. The determinant is actually the symbol like this, and A1 B2 minus A2 B1 is usually called the value of the determinant. It is also customary to write like this. One remembers the value of A1 B2 minus A2 B1 by referring the mnemonical diagram below, in particular to the arrows in the diagram. This is the mnemonical diagram. This is just for remembering how to use this determinant system. It is A1 B2 minus A2 B1 comes after you subtract after multiplying. So from here we can deduce. And theorem, a very important theorem. Said that the system this has unique solution if and only if the determinant A1 B1 A2 B2 is non-zero. If determinant is zero, then either the system has no solution or has infinite number of solution. So this means that the determinant is very crucial. It's very crucial for predicting the behavior of the system. It is also same, it also acts as the same deciding factor in the case of 3 unknown variable 1 such as a linear equation, that is a linear equation in 3 variables. So this type of determinant in which there are only 2 variables, this is known as the second order of the determinant. Before we define the third order or many other orders, we should take a look at the matrices. Now we have actually entered into the topic of the matrices. Now we will actually define what is matrices and how matrices were introduced. This whole was the introduction to the matrices, that how, why and why the matrices are important and why they have come into the existence. Now you would be thinking, what is matrix? You must have logged into this video to see what is matrix, and I told you about all his history and told how it was introduced. So now I will write the definition and it will go in fast forward. So you can pause the video after I have written to see.
A equal to 1, minus 2, 2, 4, minus 3, 1 is a matrix of 2 rows, 3 columns. You can say 2 rows, 3 columns. So the order is 2 in 2 by 3. We write as like this. So in general, a set of mn elements can be arranged as a matrix with m rows and columns. A, like this, A11, A12, A13, 1n, Aij. Here, Aij represents the elements in the ith row and the jth column. Matlab, element in the first row and the first column. First row, first column. So, if in any examiner and someone asks, like for this matrix, what is the A13 element? So this means the element in the first row and the third column. So this is that element. So answer would be this. Okay. This was a very important concept. Now let's move further. Now for this video, it is the last concept, and after this video the remaining concept will be continued next video. Now we take the next example. Here, let P be a matrix 2, 3, 51, 4, 5, -2, -1, -3, and 1. In above matrix we observe A11 equal to 2 and so on. In a compact form, any matrix A can be written as Aij m into n, where I is greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to m. Also J is greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to n. So today it is now over for the today. Now the next concept will be continued in the next video, as it becomes a very long video. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you think I have not able to explain this very good form, then I will try my best to explain all the concepts in very good manner, very entertaining manner in the next video. Please share and subscribe and like my channel and share this video to learn the concepts, to make other learn the concept of matrices and determinants. And press the bell icon and subscribe my channel, Mathematics and Beyond. Thank you.